topic of my speech is heuristics, and many of you would have heard this word, and where we mostly influence this word is in our day-to-day life, in our day-to-day decision making, personal, official, in all matters. How does heuristics influence decision, and how does sometimes it is misleading your decisions is going to be the topic, going to be the information which I wanted to share with you. I hope this session would be informative to you. Next slide. Looking at this picture, can you please conclude, match the text with the pictures? If you could able to match the text given with the pictures appropriately, then I will explain to you what is behind that. Okay. I understand that if you could able to conclude, fine. Next slide. So let me tell you what is heuristics, the definition, the right definition of heuristics. Heuristics is an approach to a problem solving that employs a practical methodology which it is not guaranteed to be optimal or perfect, but sufficient for the immediate goals. For example, we can call it as a thumb rule, or we can call it as an educational guess, intuitive judgment, and so on. Next slide. And to be more appropriate, what is heuristics? Heuristics is nothing but our brain has evolved to solve complex problems with a limited amount of information instantly, routine basis. And such routines are called heuristics. For example, if we throw a ball, okay, our brain measures the distance of the object based on the clarity of the vision that has received to our brain from our body. And sometimes it may mislead also and may result in a catastrophic failures. For example, I would say here, a pilot landing a flight on a fogging day. So that may be an intuitive judgment which may lead to a catastrophic failure, or he may land it appropriately. Again, the heuristics is the secret behind it. Next slide. So this is a pictorial information to you. When we are trying to catch a ball, we are not trying to calculate, use the projectile motion formula, but our brain can calculate the distance of the ball, and we can able to catch the ball appropriately, or sometimes we may also not catch the ball, right? Next. So these are some of the examples which I can give it to you for how heuristics works. We always presume clear is equal to near and hazy is equal to far. Sun and moon are the good examples for that. And the next one is high price is equal to high quality. For example, pizza versus dosa. The third example, known brand is equal to high quality. Again, Sony, Samsung are good examples for that. And another example, we may always think complex problem is always a complex solution. For example, rocket science. Next slide. So why we are dealing with the heuristics? Why we wanted to know about the heuristics? In all our decision making process, there are a lot of decision traps involved which we might fall prey to those decision traps without knowing the influence of heuristics in those decision making process. So I would like to highlight some of the decision traps which we may not have encountered, or we may have encountered, but this is for your information. Number one, anchoring. Anchoring is nothing but marketing. The heuristics behind that is giving a disproportionate weight to first information what we receive. The second one is status quo. The person who is suffering with status quo will always think the most real, the most recent is the present is real and future is uncertain. So he will not take any decisions. Number three, sunk cost fallacy. The person suffering from sunk cost fallacy will always think that he would prefer to lose rather than gaining. So not losing is most important for him. Number three, confirmation bias. Confirmation bias, the people suffering from confirmation bias will always think that he will pursue effort leading to reward. So his decisions, his discussions, everything, he will always say that he is already, owning that reward. So he will always end with the positive note. Overconfidence bias. Overconfidence bias is nothing but an ability of a person to capitalize his own superior knowledge, and hence, in most of the cases, even the experts will give a wrong decisions that will lead to a major loss. So I believe that these examples will suffice to make you understand how heuristics is influential in our decision making process. Next, and the conclusion here is, when I say heuristics, where I can use heuristics is suitable for decisions in uncertainty. And what is uncertainty? Uncertainty is always when there is no alternatives, no probabilities, and no consequences. And which method we need to adopt? That is, statistics is the method for decisions in risk. And to make you clear what is risk, risk is always when the alternatives, probabilities, and consequences are known. So I believe the conclusion is clear here, and heuristics plays a major role in our decision making process, and I believe that this information is sufficient for you. And in all our decision making process, if you are leading to a right decision with all this analysis, definitely you will get an applause from your subordinates, you will get an applause from your superior, from your management also. Over to Toastmasters.